A sample of clay was partially dried and then contained 50% silica and 7% water. The original clay contained 12% water, and find the percent of silica in original sample. So this is the percent of silica. It is partially dried. So we can write here percentage of that is after, you can say after partial drying, after partial drying. So what are percentage? We have three things. One is silica, second is your water, and third in this percentage, one more thing is that it's called impurity. Impurity is also there. So silica is given 50 as per the question, water is 7, and this will be total 100. So we can say 57. So 100 minus 57 is 43. Now percentage in original clay. So in original clay, you have to assume like the silica is, you have to take a, but water is given, how much it is given here? 12. So water is given 12, and impurity will be, so 100 minus 12, 88. So this will be 88 minus a. So now we can take the ratio of these two things, because the clay on heating will lose water, clay will lose water, while the percentage ratio of silica and impurities, silica and impurities will, both will be your not influenced. So we can take the ratio 50 by a is equal to 43 divided by 88 minus a. So this is our your ratio. So on solving, so you will get here, so we will get a will be equal to 47.31. so this is your percent of silica after drying in original clay. 0.05 gram of a commercial sample of KClO3 potassium chloride on decomposition is liberating just sufficient oxygen for complete oxidation of 20 ml of carbon monoxide at 27 degree centigrade and 750 millimeter pressure. What is the percentage of KClO3 in sample? Now thing is that, so if you take KClO3, so this is the KClO3, so if you heat it, it becomes KCl and plus oxygen. So if you balance it, this is your 2, and this will becomes your 2 KCl, and this is your 3 molecules of water. Means for 2 moles of KClO3, we require 3 moles of water. Sorry, 3 moles of oxygen. Now this is oxygen will utilized, it will react with which one? Carbon monoxide and plus oxygen, and it will give you carbon. So you can say carbon dioxide. So if you balance it, becomes your half. So for 1 mole, we require half mole of oxygen. So for 3 mole, how much we require oxygen? That will react with carbon monoxide to give complete carbon dioxide. So we can find the moles of carbon dioxide by using this equation. So if you see what is the moles of carbon monoxide, so we can say what is the moles of carbon monoxide. We know PV equal to nRT, that is PV equal to nRT. So this N is the moles of carbon monoxide. So N mole of carbon monoxide will be PV equal to nRT, so PV by RT. So what is PV? So PV is given 750 by 760, and volume is given 20 ml. Okay, so 20 by 1000, this is the volume, and divide by R is given your 0.0821, and temperature is 300 Kelvin. So if you solve it, on solving, you will get the moles of carbon monoxide is 8.01 into 10 to the power minus 4. This is the moles of carbon monoxide. So 1 mole will equal half mole of oxygen. So definitely moles of oxygen will be how much? So moles of oxygen will be half of this one. So this will be half into 8.01 into 10 to the power minus 4. So this is the moles of carbon oxide, oxygen. And we are saying 2 moles for KClO3, we require 3 moles of oxygen. So we can see here. So already 2 moles for require 3 moles of oxygen. So this is the total moles of oxygen. Okay. So now we can say this one. So if you take 3 moles of what? Oxygen, we require 2 moles of KClO3, because we know KClO3 mixture. So if you take this much mole, means half into 0.801 into 10 to the power minus 4. So we require definitely how much? So here we require, so it will be 2 by 3, and this is the multiplied by again half into, so it will be 8.01 into 10 to the power minus 4. So if you solve it, you will get here 2.67 into 10 to the power minus 4 mole of KClO3. This is the mole, so we have to find the mass. So mass of KClO3 is molar mass of KClO3, if you calculate, so it will come about 122.5 gram. So if you multiply it by this whole into 122.5, so you will get the mass of KClO3 in terms of gram, that is 3.27 into 10 to the power minus 2 grams. So already I have calculated, so I am writing this answer. Now they are asking what is the percentage of KClO3. So percentage of KClO3 will be, solid weight is given 3.27 into 10 to the power minus 2 gram, and the weight is given 0.05. So if you see, it is 0.05, and if you multiply by 100, so answer will be your 65.4%. So if you see the answers, so it is you can see a 0.05 again given. So percentage of KClO3 in the sample will be your 65.4%. This is our answer. When 400 gram of a 20% solution by weight is cooled, so 50 gram of solid is precipitated. So what is the percentage of concentration by weight in remaining solutions? We have to find the percentage of concentration remaining solution. So here percentage of solute is, so if you see here, what is the weight of mass of solution is given? So 20% solution is cooled. So what is the mass of solute? So mass of solute will be, we can say this is the 24%, so 20 by 100 into 400. So this will be your total 80 gram. And this 80 grams, 50 gram is precipitated. So we can say 50. So you will get here 30 grams. This is the mass of the solute in solution. This is in solution. Now they are asking mass of the solution remain. So mass of solution will be how much? So mass of solution will be 400. Okay. And then it will be your minus 50. This becomes your 350 gram. This is the mass of the solution. Now percentage concentration. So percentage by mass of concentration will be, okay, so you can see concentration. So it will be how much? So it will be your total is 30 is a solute and total is 350. So if you multiply by 100, so you will get answer, that is 8.57%. So this is our answer. Calculate the percentage by weight concentration of a solution obtained by mixing 300 gram of 25% and 400 gram of 40% solution by weight. So there are two solutions, solution 1, so this is solution 1 and this is solution 2. So if you take here solution 1, in this case mass of solute is, so mass of solute will be how much? So it is your 25% of 300. So answer will be your 75 gram. And solution 2, okay, so mass of solute will be, it is your 40% of 400. So 40% for 400 will be your, it will solve it becomes your 160 gram. So now total solute is this much value. And solution is how much? Solution is again 300 plus 400, 700. So percentage of, you can say, percentage by mass of solution, okay. So if you calculate, so it is your 25, okay, then say 75 and plus 160, and the total is your 400 plus 300, that is 700 gram. So this is nothing if you calculate here. So this will be equal to 235 and divide by 700. So you have to find the percentage, multiply by percentage, so you will get here 33.57%. So this is our answer of this whole question.